It's a gargantuan seven-storied structure with no apparent rhyme or reason.
Built on the orders of a grieving widow.
There's a lot of mythology around Sarah Winchester. You can understand it. In her lifetime, there was a legend, a mythology that grew around her, grew around the creation of this house. You know, this house was built at a time where there was nothing around here. Now it's in the middle of San Jose's main street, you know, shopping area. But at that time, it was just empty farmland around. And in the middle of this starts appearing this extraordinary, extraordinary construction, bit by bit by bit.
It's a gargantuan seven-storied structure with no apparent rhyme or reason. Each maze of halls more confusing than the next.
Built by this widow who always wears black, who no one in the town, you know, local towns ever see. She's private, she's always in her house. So you can understand a mythology starts building up about her, even in her own lifetime. And as the house became more extraordinary and more complicated and bigger and bigger, that mythology now has lasted over the years.
It's under never-ending construction.
It's amazing. It validates, you know, the work that we did on the set, you know, the construction team and all that they built, the art direction. They built amazing sets that are the same, you know? Because it's very different to walk, you know, to drive into the real thing and get out. But there's different sheds. Like in the film, you know, I drive up in a horse and cart and a buggy and get out, and there's nothing out there if you want to be palm trees. And here there's a freeway and a road and... But it's always a great reminder to know that it's a real place and that you've got to give it, you know, certain respect and dignity when you do recreate something that actually exists.
Do you believe in ghosts, Dr. Price?
I do not believe in anything I cannot see or study.
I feel their presence.
Helen has never done a haunted house or a horror movie before. So when we initially thought, gee, it'd be great to get the Helen Mirren type in this film, you know, to actually go out to her and say it, and she said yes, was a wonderful moment. And I think the reason she was interested in the project was, I think she likes haunted house scary movies, but I think she was really fascinated by the woman, Sarah Winchester. She was fascinated that she was had such an inventive mind and was such a progressive thinker, and I think Helen could really relate to her. And I think that's what she was attracted to more than anything was Sarah Winchester, the woman.
Mrs. Winchester, why all the construction?
The spirits, killed by the rifle. We lock them away.
The body of the drama we shot in Melbourne in studios where they beautifully reconstructed many of these rooms and staircases and corridors. So it was very familiar to me in that sense, coming into the house. But I was blown away by the detail, the incredible detail. I wanted to, you know, you could spend hours in each room because as small as, and that's the other amazing thing, it's the scale. It's so small, it's like a little, like a kid's house, like a little doll's house. Very feminine, but with this incredible, intricate design. Everywhere you look, there's another detail and beautiful, you know, just to look at a piece of wallpaper or a fireplace, you know, each fireplace is extraordinary.
And by the moonlight of all passed away.
You leave my family alone.